Hi everybody, Dion here. This is part two in a series about taking a document from raw data to sharing ready. This week we'll be talking about pivot tables 101. You'll recognize this as our data set from last time, so we're gonna go ahead and throw this into a pivot table. Since it's in a table right now, we can just go ahead and go to insert and pivot table. It should have all our data ready to go, table two. The first thing we're gonna do is just kind of go over these different sections down here and kind of show how they interact. So the first thing we're gonna try and do is get our month as rows. So you can see here, we have our months counting up to the end of the year. Second thing we're going to do is bring in our lead quality, which is isolated to the three different types. So we'll go ahead and show that underneath each one. Now you'll see here we have blank because quite a few of ours don't have a lead status. We're gonna go ahead and remove that by going into this, which is the filter, and remove blanks. So that gives us January, inquiry, junk, and qualified. And we wanna go ahead and see how many different leads come from each one. So ID exists on each and every section. So we're gonna go ahead and go put that under values. Instead of sum, because it's just a random number, we're gonna make this a count. So it'll count each one for each section. So you can see here, in January we had 221 inquiry, 53 junk, 89 qualified. Now, say we only wanted to use this for certain campaigns we have. If we wanted to do that, we can go ahead and use this filters group. We would toss campaign into the filter, and now we have the option to only show certain ones for each. So let's say we only want to look at campaign 3 over time. So campaign 3 only existed in June and July. That's a quick way to see how those interact. Now with these rows, we have some other options we can do. Say we want to look at lead quality as the top groups. We would see inquiry, junk, and qualified as they existed in the months moving forward. So those are the basics of a pivot table. Next week, we will go into calculated fields and how to make this data stand out for us.